Hello there. You must be Morgan age 76, right? Welcome to Southport. I'm Sowerby, the owner of this Aero Club. Here at the club, we provide all the training lessons you need to get started and earn your private pilot license. Then, once you've earned your PPL, you can build up your flight hours and get more experience by taking people out on first flights. But before any of that, let's head outside and take a flight to get familiar with our aircraft and the local surroundings.
Welcome to the apron. This is where all our flying adventures begin. Why don't you walk around a bit while I finish the pre-flight preparations? Today we will be flying in a Cessna 172 Skyhawk. It's the main trainer airplane in our flight school. Our Cessna's got a glass cockpit and a 180 horsepower engine, climbs well, and is easy to fly. It's one sweet ride. I'm ready if you are, so hop in and buckle up. Let the good times roll. I know the plane is majestic, but you should see it in the air. Get inside, so we can get started. Welcome aboard. While you settle in, let's go over our flight plan. After taking off, we will climb to 460 meters above sea level and then fly over the airport to enjoy the view. Ready? Why don't you start the engine for us? Perfect. The wind is from 270 degrees direction with a speed of 9 knots, so we'll be taking off from runway 19. Okay, let me taxi to the runway. The fun part. After releasing the brakes and applying full power, we will speed up and take off once we reach 100 kilometers per hour airspeed. We will be climbing at 139 kilometers per hour, which is the recommended climbing speed for the Cessna Skyhawk. While climbing, we will follow a left-hand traffic pattern and make two turns. Don't worry if it sounds overwhelming, I am here to help. Release the parking brakes, otherwise we're not going anywhere. Good. Ready for takeoff? Apply full power to get us moving. You handle the yoke, and I'll take care of the pedals, steering the aircraft on the runway during takeoff. We have reached 102 kilometers per hour. Pull the yoke a little bit to lift off. perfect climbing attitude and speed. I see you know what you're doing. We are approaching our first turn. As you'll see, the Cessna 172 requires very little yoke movement to turn. We are 90 meters above the ground. I will retract the flaps. You keep climbing, you can start turning left. Keep climbing and prepare for the next turn. Okay, turn left again. We are almost there. Remember, we need to climb to 460 meters. It will keep us 150 meters above the traffic pattern. Love the weather today. The clouds are beautiful, aren't they? There we are, 460 meters above sea level and 150 meters above the traffic pattern. We have safe separation with the other airplanes. Look around, see our airport? Let's fly over it. Awesome. I know that you're busy navigating and controlling the plane, but don't forget to enjoy the view. Well done. I believe you have a talent for piloting. I hope you enjoyed the flight. Let's head back to the ground now.
I'm glad that we flew together today. This might be the first chapter in your pilot's journey, if you want to embark on it. Let's catch up at our headquarters. You seemed comfortable out there. I'm sure you'll get your PPL in no time. There's a laptop in the office that shows all the certification information you'll need for your PPL exam. Take a look. Here you can see all the different certifications you can pass throughout your career. Your first step is to work towards your private pilot license. All the training lessons you'll need to pass the PPL exam are available here. Make sure you're comfortable with these before taking the exam.
Welcome to Sedona. I'm Captain Jess Molina, and I'll be your instructor. For this lesson, we're going to start on the ground and focus on some basic concepts. Fundamentals every pilot needs to know before hitting the skies. Okay. This is your plane, a classic, the Cessna 172. Take a look around it. In the simulator, anytime you want, you can easily switch to cursor mode. The cursor is handy for interacting with menus and cockpit controls or instruments. As you can see, activating the cursor also displays the toolbar at the top of the screen. The toolbar is a quick access menu that allows you to control various aspects of the simulation. Try to find and open the controls panel. The controls panel is a useful reminder of the button layout for the devices you're currently using. Now try to find and open the camera panel in the toolbar. The camera panel allows you to access the various views and camera modes of the simulation. Go ahead and close all the panels for now. In front of you is the yoke, the primary means of controlling the aircraft. In the simulation, you will be controlling the aircraft with your peripherals of choice. So, let's hide the yoke for now. All right, as we've seen, when you all look around you, it's easy to rotate the camera. But you can also move it freely in the cockpit to get a better view of anything you want to see. Even through a window to look outside. Now, reset the camera to its original position. All right. That covers all the main camera functions available in the simulation. Try to familiarize yourself with them a bit more, then reset the camera to its original position whenever you're done. Great. Let's get you familiar with the aircraft, a Cessna 172, and a few commands to navigate it through the skies. In front of you is the yoke. The yoke is like a steering wheel, more or less. Turn it left or right to control the ailerons and bank the aircraft into turns. Look at the trailing edge of the wings while turning the yoke to see the effect on the ailerons. Okay. Now, the difference between the yoke and a steering wheel is you can pull or push on the yoke. This controls the elevator at the back of the aircraft to make it climb or descend. Look at the horizontal stabilizer while you pull on the yoke. You can see how it affects the elevator. Nice. Down at your feet are the rudder pedals. They steer the aircraft when you're on the ground. The upper part of the pedals also control your brakes. In the air, they control the rudder at the end of the vertical stabilizer to yaw the aircraft. This is mostly for small corrections. For coordinating turns or compensating for a plane's tendency to pull left during takeoffs and climbs. Look at the vertical tail while operating the pedals to see the effect on the rudder.
Great.
Last but not least, the throttle is located near the center of the cockpit. Pushing forward will increase power, pulling back will decrease power. First, look at the throttle and select it. Keep it selected, and push it forward to increase power. Power is increased. Now pull it back to decrease power. Power is decreased. Now we'll do the same without focusing on it. Deselect the throttle. Look away from the throttle and increase power. Set your throttle to idle. Excellent. When the engine is on, you'll be able to see the power change on your RPM indicator. You will find it on your PFD screen in the top left corner. This tells you how fast the engine is spinning in hundreds of revolutions per minute. Next, take a look at your current speed on the airspeed indicator. It's on the left on your PFD screen. It measures the speed in knots. To check your altitude, look to the altimeter. It's on the right on your PFD screen. Not all aircraft have integrated screens with all this information. A lot of them rely on analog instruments. You can find the analog versions of the airspeed indicator and the altimeter just above the throttle. They are respectively on the left and right. The analog altimeter has three hands similar to a clock. The long, thick pointer indicates 100-foot intervals, the short, thick one is 1,000-foot intervals, and the long, thin one counts 10,000-foot intervals. That's all for today. Next time, we'll see how it feels in the air. To help demonstrate pitch, I've drawn three lines on the windshield. Notice how the middle line matches the horizon while we're flying level? This is the cruise attitude. The lower dotted line is the climb attitude, and the upper one is the descent attitude. Let's dig deeper into what that means. Pull back gently on the yoke until the climb attitude line matches the horizon. Then maintain that attitude. According to your altimeter, we're gaining altitude. But we're losing airspeed, proving you can't avoid basic physics while making a climb. Excellent. That's good. Keep working on it, you'll get better. Now, let's level back out. Our speed is increasing and our altitude is stable. All right. That's good. That's okay. Push gently on the yoke until the descent attitude line matches the horizon. Then maintain that attitude. As expected, with a nose-down attitude, our altitude is decreasing while our speed is picking up.
Great.
That's good. Keep working on it, you'll get better. Okay, bring us back to level flight. Now your speed is decreasing and your altitude is stable. That's good. That's okay. That was excellent. Being able to maintain a precise and stable attitude is key to performing all types of maneuvers. For this lesson, we're going to use a line drawn on the windshield to indicate the crew's attitude. I've also added another dotted line to help you bank properly for left turns. Gently move the yoke to the left until the dotted line matches up with the horizon. Then maintain that bank. That's good. Watch your altitude. It wasn't constant during the turn. Now, let's see you level back out. All right. For the next step, turning to the right, let's see how you do on your own, without any markings. You can see a series of notches representing 10-degree increments on the attitude indicator part of your PFD. As a general rule, you always want to keep your turns under 30 degrees. Start banking right until you're lined up with the second notch to the right on the attitude indicator. Then, maintain that 20-degree bank while remaining at the same altitude until I ask you to stop. Level us back out now.
Great.
Remember, during a turn the aircraft tends to sink, you need to pull on the yoke to compensate. Let's talk about the throttle. If you have the need for speed, then the throttle's for you. Full control over the power output of the engine. In the Cessna 172, that relates directly to the RPM displayed on the tachometer on the PFD. Pull back on the throttle to reduce RPM to 1800. Look how your speed and altitude are also decreasing. Excellent. Okay, let's throttle back up to 2,400 RPM. Your speed is increasing now. As long as you maintain the same attitude, your altitude will keep climbing as well. Nice. That was excellent. With piston planes like this Cessna, it's common to have power targets defined in RPM. The art of maneuvering a plane through the air isn't a mystery to you anymore. Now it's time to test the skills you've learned. As you can see, we're cruising at 6,000 feet on a north heading of 360 degrees. Start by descending to 5,500 feet while maintaining a northerly heading. While descending, reduce throttle to avoid overspeed. If your speed is in the yellow section of the airspeed indicator, it means you are overspeeding. Reduce throttle to idle and pull gently on the yoke to slow down. While descending, reduce throttle to avoid overspeed. That's good. Now, climb to 6,000 feet and turn to a south heading. On the Cessna 172, you need full power to climb effectively. Nice. All right, next exercise. Maintain your heading of 180 degrees, stay at 6,000 feet, and adjust your airspeed to 80 knots. All right. That was excellent.